हॅलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिस्टर चांगले संकेत सुरेंद्र, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम मुळा एज्युकेशन सोसायटीज, मुळा रुरल इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ फार्मसी सोनी. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ डेंटल अँड कॉस्मेटिक प्रिपरेशन्स पार्ट थर्ड. इन दिस चॅप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द व्हेरियस टाईप्स ऑफ कंटेंट्स सच ॲज इंट्रोडक्शन, क्लासिफिकेशन, फेशियल कॉस्मेटिक्स, डिओड्रंट्स अँड अँटीपर्स्पिरंट, शॅम्पूज. नाव we have discussed this all of the above points. Now today we are going to discuss the hair dressings and hair removers with dentifrices. Learning outcome: at the end of this chapter, the learner will be able to know that or understand that what do we mean by hair dressings and hair removers, and what do we mean by a dentifrices. Now starting with the hair dressings. Hair dressings are applied to dry hair in order to provide extra gloss. The main purpose of hair dressing is to apply a thin film of oil to keep the hair in order to give a natural looking gloss without any appearance of the oiliness. Qualities or properties of hair dressings: it should be non-toxic to the skin, it should provide luster to the hair without greasiness. And it provides some degree of hair conditioning. There are number of preparations which are used for hair by men and women are as follows. First one is the hair conditioners, second one is the hair tonics, third one is the brilliantines, fourth one is the hair weaving and hair straightening preparations. Now we will start with the first one, hair conditioners. Hair conditioners are those preparations which reduces the fluffiness and smoothness of hair shafts. They are used to make the hair manageable, glossy and of soft texture. Hair conditioners are generally used for those hairs which are damaged by over shampooing, bleaching and dyeing. Hair conditioners are sometimes used for shampooing the hair. This is done to remove the detergent film which has been left by shampoo. The hair becomes too soft to touch after this. Second one is the hair tonics. These are applied to the hair for curing baldness, giving relief to oily or dry skin and to prevent the cure of dandruff. Hair tonic generally contains a rubefacient, antiseptic and sebaceous gland stimulant. Hair tonic should be rubbed into the scalp at night so that it can be removed by shampooing the hair on the next day. Third one is the brilliantines. These are mainly used by men to impart luster to the hair, also for keeping the hair in a place. After initial setting of the hair, liquid brilliantine is sprayed on the hair with an solid brilliantines. Now we will see the liquid brilliantines. Liquid brilliantines consist of a mineral oil with deodorized kerosene or isopropyl myristate. An alkaline brilliantine is a solution of oils in alcohol. It spreads easily, giving the feeling of freshness and stimulate the skin. Example is castor oil and almond oil. Solid brilliantines. These are thickened by adding different waxes such as beeswax, carnauba wax, paraffin wax, spermaceti, etc. Aluminium tristerate is used as gelling agent for transparent brilliantines. Fourth point is the hair weaving and hair straightening preparations. These days, both men and women are conscious about their hairstyle. People having curly hair are interested to make it straight, and those who have straight hair are very keen to make them curly. The curling of the hair requires some special devices like brush, hot air blower and combs. The curl produced by this method is temporary. Various improved methods has been developed to produce better curls. Nowadays, hair weaving liquids are available in the market which have shown a promising result. Hair weaving liquids consist of a thick colloidal solution of gum caraya, gum acacia, gum tragacanth, etc. Now starting with the hair dyes. Changed with age are converted into black color with the help of hair dyes in order to restore the youthful appearance. Sometimes hair dyes are used to alter the color of the hair temporarily for a particular occasion. These hair dyes are classified to the duration of action as temporary, semi-permanent and permanent dyes. Hair dyes are conventionally divided into three classes: vegetable dyes, metallic dyes and synthetic organic dyes. Now the another point is the depilatories. Depilatories means a hair removers. These days the women are very conscious about their beauty. They do not like the unwanted growth of hair on their body. The unwanted hair from the skin can be removed by the three methods: epilation method, depilation method and electrolysis method. Now we will see the first method, epilation method. Epilation method means the uprooting of intact hair mechanically by plucking or embedding in adherent material such as wax, rosin, etc. It is a painful process and may cause skin damage. The chances of infection of skin is increased by this method. The formulation of epilatory generally contains rosin, beeswax, along with the mineral oils, local anesthetic and bacterial agents. Second method is the depilation method. The chemicals most commonly used for this purpose are sulfides of barium, calcium and strontium. Calcium thioglycerol and calcium thioglycolate are also used. Out of these chemicals, calcium sulfide is the most popular depilating agent because it has excellent depilating properties without serious effects. Third one is the electrolysis method. In this method, it involves the inserting of needle into the hair follicle and hair root is completely destroyed by means of weak DC current. The hair is removed permanently. The method is very expensive and time consuming, but once the treatment is given successfully, the hair does not grow again. Here in the figure you can see how this method works. Now starting with the anti-dandruff preparations. Dandruff is common condition among men and women of all the ages. It often causes skin irritation, embarrassment and annoyance to the sufferers. In dandruff, the outer layer of the epidermis of the skull is not powdered off, but its shades is relatively in a large scales. Any preparation which clears the skull from adherent material and regulates the amount of residual skull and hair oil to retain healthy condition of the skull is known as anti-dandruff preparation. The main causes of dandruff are dysfunction, dandruff may lead to the loss of hair. It can be controlled by shampooing. The proper cleanliness of the scalp is of great importance. Mechanical massage of the scalp or thorough brushing of hair with clean brush both before and after shampoo is very helpful. The frequent washing of hair is very important with shampoos. While using shampoo, it should be allowed to remain in the hair for about half an hour and the hairs are thoroughly washed with a warm water. After proper drying of hair, it should be massaged and brushed to increase the blood circulation of the scalp. This was the anti-dandruff preparation. Here you can see the anti-dandruff preparation along with the formula. In formula, it consists of selenium disulfide, stabilizer, surfactant and water. Now, starting with the last point, dentifrices. Dentifrices are the preparations meant to be applied to the teeth with a toothbrush for the purpose of cleaning an accessible surface of the teeth. Dentifrices are used in the following cases: for cleansing of tooth, polishing of tooth, etc. Now, here you can see the formulation of dentifrices. It consists of abrasive agents, binders and detergents. Abrasive agents are also known as polishing agents and are used to remove debris and residual . The cleansing of an abrasive depends on the size, shape, hardness and the brittleness. The commonly used abrasives are precipitated calcium carbonate, calcium phosphate, etc. Binders are used to keep the solids and liquids in the united form to maintain the consistency. The commonly used binders are gum tragacanth, sodium alginate, methyl cellulose, etc. Gum tragacanth is generally used because it maintains the consistency weather resistance and is not affected by pH changes. It is used in the concentration of 1 to 2.5%. The exact amount of binding agent which is required in dentifrices depends upon the consistency of the preparations. Detergents. These are the surface active agents which are used to enhance the action of abrasives. They lower the surface tension, penetrate and loosen the surface deposit and emulsify or suspend the debris. The commonly used detergents are sodium lauryl sulfate and sodium alkyl sulfosuccinate. Surfactants also lower the abrasive effect of toothbrush and abrasives. Flavoring agents. These are included in the preparation to impart the flavor to the preparation. The most commonly used flavoring agents are peppermint oil, cinnamon oil, etc. Humectants. These are used in the toothpaste to retain moisture and will not allow the paste to become dry. It also helps Orbitol, etc. Preservatives. This includes in dentifrices formulation to prevent the growth of bacteria in toothpaste. Methyl paraben and propyl paraben are generally used for this purpose. Sweetening agents, which included in the dentifrices to impart sweet taste to the preparation. Saccharin is the most commonly used sweetening agent. Therapeutic agents. This includes the medicated toothpaste in order to check dental diseases and to remove bad smell. The commonly used therapeutic agents are antibiotics, fluorides, etc. Now, the various formulations of dentifrices. In figure, you can see liquid dentifrices, tooth powders and toothpaste. Now, starting with the first one, liquid dentifrices. These are the preparations which are not much popular, but still they are used for tooth cleaning purposes. They are basically aqueous or hydroalkaline solution of surfactants in which thickening agent, sweeteners, flavors are added. Method: dissolve the soap, saccharin and volatile oils in alcohol, then add amaranth solution and sufficient water to make 100 ml. Sprinkle on the moistened toothbrush and use as a dentifrice. Now the tooth powders. These are the oldest, cheapest and simple preparations meant for cleansing the teeth. The main ingredient having very fine particle size. Toothpaste. These are the most popularly and widely used preparations for cleaning the teeth. They are more expensive as compared to the tooth powders, but still they are more preferred. The main ingredient in the toothpaste are abrasives, foaming agent, sweetening agent, flavoring, flavors, binding agent, humectants, preservatives and therapeutic agents. Here we are ending with the chapter Dental and Cosmetic Preparations. Thank you very much.